Anxious attachment. Coping strategies to deal with anxiety, insecurity, fear of abandonment, and reconnect with your partner. Written by Janis Bryans. Narrated by Andrea Webster. Introduction. Do you feel like you live in fear of losing your partner? Do you find yourself obsessively worrying about what they're doing when they aren't by your side? Does it feel like the only time anyone really listens to you is when they're looking for advice on how to make their own life better? If this is familiar, then there's a good chance that one or both partners have an anxious attachment style. You may have an insecure attachment style and not even be aware of it. Lots of people do. In fact, it's not entirely uncommon for a secure person to marry an anxious one, and then, 15 years into marriage, start having panic attacks. Or maybe you were anxious when you started dating your partner, but thought that things would change once you had children, and/or were living together for a while. It's only now that you're beginning to wonder if this may be an ongoing issue. But maybe your history reads something more like this. You were the anxious one in the relationship. You didn't trust other people enough to let them get close to you. You dated anxious people because it seemed inevitable that they would reject you. But they didn't, and you figured that they might be able to teach you how to stop being so clingy. But now, 10 or 15 years later, they're still doing the same things that they were doing at the beginning, and so are you. And now, maybe your partner is starting to say things like, "You're too sensitive," or "You're making me feel guilty," or "Just calm down, it's not that bad." Or maybe he or she thinks that you're in denial about how bad things are. Or maybe he or she doesn't understand why they just can't get more of what they want. If this sounds familiar, you may be an anxious attachment partner. You may not be enjoying the quality of your relationship because your partner is always so anxious, and you aren't feeling secure enough to share what's on your mind, let alone give them your full attention. And if things aren't going particularly well in your romantic relationship, you may find yourself in similar situations in your other relationships too. Just like any other type of relationship, relationships with an anxious attachment style include the good and the bad. There may be many wonderful things about how your partner acts when he or she is not anxious. There may also be many very frustrating things about how your partner acts when he or she is anxious. And of course, there will always be moments when you become frustrated about how your partner is acting and will share your frustration with them. When you do this, it can feel like a huge step forward, but it can also bring up all kinds of resentment. You may get the sense that they don't really get what you're saying, or that they're taking it too personally, or that they're just being defensive. If that sounds familiar, then maybe your relationship is in trouble. But it's not solely your fault. Your partner may well be anxious, and this may be why he or she is acting the way they are. So, what does all of this mean? What can you do about it? How do you stop feeling insecure enough to avoid acting in ways that lead to anxiety? And what can you do if your partner is the one who needs help, but they don't want to talk about it or go there? While you may not be taking your partner's issues seriously enough, it's also possible that they're taking them too seriously. They may be unable to cope with their anxiety, as it's rooted in trauma from their past. If you can find a way to work through these anxiety triggers together, you could help your partner grow in a new and very positive direction. But if you can't communicate with each other in a way that makes it easier to deal with these issues, then there's a good chance that your relationship will continue to suffer. On the other hand, it's also possible that you're just as anxious as they are and just don't know it. If this is the case, you may be acting like an anxious attachment partner without even realizing it. If you're not even aware of the problem, then it won't get any better. But if you realize this and get help for yourself, then maybe you can actually get somewhere with your relationship. Helping your partner through their anxiety isn't always easy. It might be very painful for them to talk about their problems, and this can lead to denial, anger, and other defenses where they try harder to make their anxiety go away without getting any help. For both partners, it's important that you keep trying and that you keep reaching out, even if it's not easy at first. If this leaves you feeling unsure of what to do, there are plenty of other resources out there to help you figure out how to deal with your own feelings. If you're hoping to read about how to deal with your anxious relationship, then keep reading. This book will help you determine if your relationship is a victim of your partner's anxiety, or if you're just as anxious as they are. Whatever the issues, this book will help you understand how to cope with it. There are thousands of people out there who have been through the same thing before, and you can learn from them. You don't have to go on suffering alone. Some people are pretty insecure, but if they feel like they can find an anxious partner, then they might decide that this will be enough to make them feel better about themselves. Others might decide that an anxious partner will be a challenge, but it will also be a fix-me-up project that will give their life meaning. It's important to remember that if you do find yourself in an anxious relationship, it isn't necessarily a bad thing. It could be one of the best things that have happened to you, because it could help you deal with your own anxiety. It could even be the push that you need to deal with your anxiety. If you're in an anxious relationship, this doesn't mean that it's impossible for you to change. There are people out there who have had success dealing with their anxiety and the anxiety issues of the people around them. In this book, you'll find out more about how to make it happen for you. Chapter 1. What is anxious attachment? Anxious attachment is an inflexible pattern of behavior in which the individual constantly fears abandonment, is dependent on the relationship for emotional stability and comfort, and seeks frequent reassurance. Anxious attachment leads to feelings of insecurity when separation occurs, which can lead to a conflict with friends or family members who may not want to continue supporting an individual in this way. An individual with anxious attachment often has a hard time reaching out without feeling rejected by others. For example, if an individual has just lost a loved one, he or she may struggle to open up about the loss or share his or her feelings with others for fear of being called weak or inadequate, even though acceptance and support are what they really need. As a result, anxious people are frequently unable to seek help until it's too late. Moreover, an individual with anxious attachment often has a hard time making ordinary decisions, such as searching for a job, moving to another city, or attending school. This is because they're too focused on their own fears of being abandoned by others. For example, an individual with anxious attachment might choose to postpone entering into a romantic relationship due to fears of being abandoned by their partner. Anxious attachment is based on the idea that human infants need an emotional bond with their caregiver in order to survive and thrive. They often cry for hours if they're separated from their caregiver, usually their parents, and will not be soothed until they're reunited with them. While some experts believe that anxious attachment is a learned behavior, others believe it's genetically inherited and cannot be changed. The need for this bond is very important in the development of the child's psyche. If the caregiver is constantly responsive and sensitive to the child, he or she will learn to trust others and develop a sense of security in their relationship. On the other hand, if the caregiver is emotionally unavailable and/or rejecting, the child is likely to display anxious behavior when facing separation in adulthood. Anxious attachment patterns often develop in early childhood, when children become aware of their very own feelings for the first time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.